Good morning, my dear students. Today we will learn different types of functions and scope of variables. A user-defined function can be function with no argument and no return value, function with arguments but no return value, function with arguments and return value, or function with no argument but return value. See the first case, function with no argument and no return. In the given example, welcome, this function does not accept any parameter and the function calling statement does not pass any argument too. After executing this function, it is not returning anything to the calling statement too. So that is function with no argument and no return. Nothing is passing, nothing is returning. Next case, function with argument but no return value. In this example, the table function pass a parameter, that is num. It prints the multiplication table of num2. After printing, it is not returning anything to the calling statement. See the calling statement, table of n. This statement pass an argument to the function definition, but after executing this function definition, it is not returning anything to the calling statement. So that is function with argument but no return value. We are passing something to the function definition, but we are not returning anything from the function definition. See the next example, average function with 4 parameters. If there are more than one argument in a function definition, separate them using comma. And after executing the function definition, it is not returning anything to the function calling statement, but it passes some arguments. So argument 2 separate using comma. It prints the average of n1, n2, n3 and n4. Next case, function with argument and return value. A function can return any value using a return keyword. And another thing is, the return value must be used at the calling place by either store it in any variable or use a print statement or use in any expression. Let us understand the same using the following example. See the first program segment, def cube of num. This is a function definition and it returns num into num into num. It returns the cube of the given number using a return statement. And the top level statement, num n1 equal to int of input enter any number, c equal to cube of n1. The former case, we simply call the function with the function name and the arguments. But in this case, we assign the result to another variable. And execution time, while reaching cube of n1, it moves to the function definition with the value of n1. And it finds out the cube of num, then returns the value to the calling statement. It replaces the cube of n1 with the value of the return statement. So c equal to, it replaces that value. For example, if the user given number n1 is 2, it finds 2 into 2 into 2, that is 8. So it substitute the calling statement as c equal to 8. Then it prints cube of number is 8. See the next example, function definition is same. And see the top level statement, n1 equal to int input enter any number. We can consider the same example. Let n1 is 2. Then print cube of number is cube of n1. This is the function calling. While reaching the function calling, it just moves to the function definition, then return the result. Here in this example, if n1 is 2, the result will be 8. And it replaces the function calling statement with the value 8. Then it prints cube of number is 8. See the major difference. The first case we assign the resultant value to a variable, then prints. And the later case, we use the function calling statement as part of the print statement, then directly we print the same. So these are the first two cases, either store it in a variable or use a print statement. In this case too, function definition is same. See the calling statement as part of the top level statements. VAL equal to n1 plus cube of n1. It calls the function with the argument n1. While reaching the function calling, it moves to the function definition, then return with the resultant value. Then VAL equal to n1 plus the value which is returned by cube. It replaces the function calling statement with the return value of cube of n1. Then suppose the value of n1 is 2. It returns 2 into 2 into 2, that is 8. Then this statement becomes VAL equal to 2 plus 8. See the main difference between these three programs. First one, all the programs, the function definition is same. The first case, it assigned the function calling statement to a variable. And the next case, we use the function calling statement as part of a print statement. And the third case, we use the function calling statement with an expression. These are the three different ways to return a value from a function. First one, assign a variable. Second one, use it part of a print statement. And the third one is use that function calling statement in an expression. And see the fourth case. Here the top level statements same with the first example. And the function definition slight change is there. The former cases we return the resultant value. And this case we assign the cube of num to a variable. We return that variable too. This is almost the same. And the last case, function with no argument but return value. This case, this function is not accepting any argument, but it returns one value to the function calling statement. We can start with the function calling statement x equal to fact. While calling this statement, it moves to the function definition. F becomes 1. It let the user to enter one number to find the factorial. It finds the factorial, return the value of f to the calling statement. It substitute function fact with the return value of f. Then it prints the factorial equal to x. See, the main difference is it is not passing any argument, but it returned the value from the function definition to the main. So we can summarize all the four cases: function without argument and without return, function with argument and without return, function without argument and with return, function with argument and with return. Function without argument and without return. In this example, function fact does not accept any parameter and it is not returning anything to the function calling statement too. It prints the result here in the function definition. And in function with argument and without return case, fact function accept a parameter, and after executing the function, it is not returning anything to the function calling statement. And in function calling statement, it pass an argument and it never receive anything. And in third case, function without argument and with return. In this case, it is not passing any parameter, but it returns the result. After executing the program, it returns the result to the variable p. See the function calling statement, b equal to function calling. If a function is returning something, either it can be assigned to a variable, okay, say, then otherwise write it as part of a printf statement. And the third case, you can write it as part of an expression too. Here in this case, we assign the value to a variable. And the fourth case, function with argument and with return. Both argument and return, both are there. And here in function definitions case, we pass an argument and it receives the parameter. Then next, after executing, it returns the result to the function calling statement. So b equal to fact of n. We are passing argument, we are returning the result. So the major difference between with or without argument and with or without return is, in case of with argument, we are accepting the value in function stop level statement, then we pass the value to the function definition. In other words, input in top level statement, and in case of function return, we are printing the result in function stop level statement only. We are not in case of return, function with return, we are returning the value to the top level statement through the function calling, and we are not printing anything inside the function definition. And function without return case, we are not returning anything, we print the output here in the function definition only. So this argument and return both are connected to input and output. So with argument case, input in top level statement. Without argument means input in function definition. With return means output in top level statement. Without return means output in function definition. Please keep these two statements in your memory. Then you can write any function with return or without return, then with argument or without argument. Scope of variables. Scope means in which parts of the program a particular piece of code or data is accessible or not. That is, in which all area a particular variable is accessible is known as scope. In Python, there are two kinds of scopes: global scope and local scope. Global scope means a name declared in top level statement of a program. And a global scope variable can be used inside the entire program. And another type of global scope variable, a variable defined outside all functions, are also global variables. So if you declare some variables as part of top level statements, they have access in the entire program. Or if you declare a variable outside all the function, that variable also can be accessible in entire program. And local scope means local scope variable can be used only inside a function block. A name declared in a function body is said to have local scope. And the formal parameters of a function also have local scope. So global scope, there are two kinds of global scope variables in a program. First one, all the variables declared in top level statements. And second one, all the variables declared outside all the function. And local scope too, there are two types of local scope variables. First one, a variable declared inside functions are local scope, or the formal parameters of all the function may have local scope. See this example, function area with two parameters, length and breadth. It finds the area, then returns the result, that is A, to the calling statement. See, in this function, we declare a single variable A. A is local to function area because A is declared inside the function definition. Similarly, the variable length and breadth are the formal parameters for the function area. So, these length and breadth also have local scope. So, for the function area, A, length and breadth are local to the same. And these are the top level statements. L equal to int input, enter the length. And B, int input, enter the breadth. These two variables, not only the same, next one, AR equal to area of LB. Here there are three variables, L, B and AR. All the three variables are global to the entire program. That means we can use L, B and AR anywhere in this program. Next example, function area with the same argument, A returns the same result and the calling statement too. Here in this print statement, I used area equal to area of rectangle equal to A here. A is a variable which is local to the function area. We cannot use A outside this function, even if it is part of top level statement. So, this statement produces an error message like name A is not defined. It is not accessible here because it is declared in function area. So, scope is local to area. I hope it is understood. Next example. In this example, length, breadth and A are local to function area and L, B and AR are global variables. This L, B or AR I can use inside this program. I mean anywhere in this program. So, here I use area of circle equal to AR here. Even if AR is not declared anywhere here. But I can use it because the scope of AR is global. The variable AR is accessible in function show area because it is having global scope. If a variable is having global scope, it can be used anywhere in the program. But if it has local scope, it can be used only inside that function. Next example, here I use another variable x equal to 10. I declare that variable outside all the functions. So, this x can be considered as a global variable. Because global variables case, there are two cases. One is if a variable which is used in or declared in top level statement, that is global, and if a variable which is declared outside all the function, that is global. This is another example, m equal to 100. Here there are two global variables, x and m. I can use this x and m anywhere in this program. We can see the output of this program. M equal to 100, print value of global variable equal to m. It prints value of global variable m equal to 100, value of m. Next, value of global variable x equal to 10, because it can be accessible here. It has global scope. And the next one is find function. It may move to the function definition. A becomes 15, B becomes 20. Then value of local variables A comma B. It prints value of local variables 15, 20. Next statement, value of global variable x equal to x. It prints value of global variable x equal to value of x, that is 10. This is accessible because it is global variable. Next, value of global variable m equal to the value of m, that is 100. This m is also accessible here because that is part of top level statement. Next is lifetime of variable. Lifetime is the time for which a variable lives in computer memory. This lifetime and scope are connected. Scope means the accessibility and lifetime means the availability. For global variables, the lifetime is entire program run. That is, as long as the program is executing, the global variable lives in computer memory. For local variables, the lifetime is their functions run. That means, as long as the function is executing, it lives in memory. After finishing its execution, it is erased from the computer memory. See this example. The global variable x and m, its lifetime is the entire program run. And the local variable a and b, these variables lifetime is only inside the function execution. After finishing the function calling, it is free up from the computer memory. Python use four different environment to use variables. They are built-in namespace or environment, global namespace, enclosing namespace, and local namespace. When you access a variable from within a program or function, Python follows name resolution rule. That is LEGB rule. For example, if you are trying to access or use a variable, Python first check whether that variable is available in local. If so, it may access the same. Otherwise, it check whether it is in enclosing environment. If it is there, it use the same. Otherwise, in global environment. If it is there in global environment, it use the same. Or else it may move to the built-in environment, and if it is not there in built-in environment, it reports an error message. See, once again, first it check in local environment, whether the name is in local environment. If yes, Python uses its value, otherwise moves to second step. Then check whether it is in enclosing environment. If yes, Python uses its value, otherwise move to third case. Check in global environment. If it is available there, Python uses it, otherwise moves to the fourth environment, that is built-in environment. If it is there, Python uses its value, otherwise Python would report an error message as the name or variable is not defined. We can make it clear using the following example. This is an output prediction question, check function, and I used the same variable here in the local space or local environment and the global space or global environment. Here I assigned value 100 to variable 2. See, if a local and global variable with the same name, local variable hides the global variable's value. We can see the output. It starts execution from top level statement, that is first statement will be value equal to 600. It assigns 600 to the variable value, then prints 600. So first it print 600. Next one is a function calling statement, check function. It moves to the function definition, value equal to 100. So now the variable value which is available here in this function definition is this value. And it's even if that value is a global variable, normal case a global variable's value will be available here in the local space. But here it hide in local space, it hide the value 100. Because if the same variable is used both in global and local environment, the global environment variable will be hidden. So check function will print the value of the variable value. It prints only 100. And next statement, print value. Here it retains the value of 600. Here in the global environment, because in local environment only it hides the value of the variable with global scope. I hope it is understood. Once again, if local and global variable with the same name, under the local namespace only the local variable's value is retaining, the other value will be hidden. Next one, this is another case. Here I use a variable, global variable value. Same case, it assigns 600 to the variable value. Then prints the value. It will print 600 there. Then I call the check function. See, in check function, I use an extra statement, global value. So by using this global keyword here before a global variable's name, that means it retains the global variable's value here under the local space too. So we can see, to use a global variable instead of creating a new local variable, use the keyword global. We can see the output. First value becomes 600, it prints the value, that is 600, then check function, it move to the and value equal to 100. I change the variable's value as 100, then print value, it prints 100 only. But while coming back, the next statement, print value, it retained the value of the global variable which I changed in local environment, so that it prints 100. So if you want to retain the value of global environment, then better use global keyword. So using global variable value in local scope, use a global keyword. Let us understand the execution of the following program based on the LEGB rule. Line number 1, DEF statement is encountered, so line number 2 and 3 are ignored. Then line number 4, A equal to int input enter a number. Now a global environment is created for the same program and variable A is added to the global environment. Next, line number 5. B is also created and added to the global environment of the same program. Next is C equal to calculate AB. A function calculate is called. So the next statement is line number 1. Then variable X and Y are created and added to the local environment of calculate function. Z equal to X plus Y, that is line number 2. Now one more variable Z is added to the local environment of calculate function. Next is line number 3. A return statement encountered. Then it moves to line number 6. C is assigned with the return value. By that time, the local environment expires and it removes from the computer memory. And next statement is print sum equal to C. It prints the value of C. Now program is over, so the global environment also removed from the computer memory. So this is the execution of a program based on LEGB rule. So first it check whether that variable is there in local environment. If not, move to the enclosing environment. Otherwise, move to the global environment. Then move to the built-in environment. So while executing a program, it first check whether the variable is available in local environment. Every time when a local environment encounters, it creates its own variables and store it in local environment of the same function. When the function calling expires, that particular environment is removed from the computer memory. When a program is over, the global environment of that program also removed from the computer memory. We have learned types of functions and scope of variables. A function can be written with or without arguments and with or without returns too. Scope of a variable means the part of a program in which a particular variable is accessible. The scope can be global or local. Global scope variables are written in top level statements, or the variables declared outside all the functions are treated as global variables. And a local variable means a variable which is declared inside a function body. The formal parameters of functions are considered as local variables. The lifetime of global variable is the entire program run, and the lifetime of a local variable is the block run or the function run. And last, we have seen the accessibility rule, that is LEGB. To access a variable in a program, the interpreter follows the LEGB rule. That is, first it checks whether that variable is available in local environment. If not, follow to the enclosing environment. Otherwise, check whether it is there in the global environment. At last, it checks whether it is there in the built-in environment too. So dear students, study well and practice the programs. Thank you.